Okay, welcome everyone to Divine Lotus Tarot. We are taking a look at April 2021 Soulmate Love Reading. I know it's been a while. I hope you all are doing amazing and wonderful. I appreciate you all who continue to stay subscribed to my channel and who just transitioned with me, with everything going on over to reading the blog that I was putting up on my website. So I still will be continuing doing that because I like the diversity of being able to actually write and also being able to record the videos. So I'm still going to do that format over there for those of you who enjoy that, for the element groups. And then we're getting back into the swing of things over here. We're starting off just generally with the collective, and then eventually, I may go back into doing each zodiac sign. But like I said, let's just get back into the swing of things. I already have everything shuffled out for you all. We're going to look at your side, which is, we'll call you all Person A, those of you watching and inquiring over here, picking up on your energy, and then whoever you are inquiring about, they're going to be considered Person B, just so we don't get anything confused. And this also, for some of you, just want to put this disclaimer out there, it could be multiple people. So just make sure you only take with you the things that resonate with you, that's coming through on your side, because this is a general reading. And as far as the Person B side, like I said, if it's multiple people who some of you may be dealing with, because for whatever reason that came through that I needed to make that clear, then just take the bits and pieces that apply to each individual if it all doesn't fit one person, okay? So getting right into it, we have your headspace coming up as the Queen of Cups, okay? And your person's headspace, dun dun dun, we have them coming up as the High Priestess. Now the interesting thing is, when I pulled this, I thought both of you were coming up as the King and the Queen of Cups, but I mean the colors are pretty similar, right? So, I mean, there is some type of similarity that I'm picking up between you and whoever you're connecting to. For those of you who are aware of who this is, then you are definitely both very intuitive individuals, I would say. For whatever reason, I'm hearing that you all are very inquisitive. So you all can be very inquisitive individuals, really operating in your heart space. But I'm getting inquisitive, very intuitive, and I feel for majority of you all, you are in a very open space to, receive love. With this Queen of Cups here, it's a feminine energy, so I feel, this represents the energy of individuals who are very receptive to giving love. But not only that, I feel like you guys are also very receptive to receiving love, right? And whoever you're dealing with, for those of you who actually know who this person could be coming off as, very mysterious. They're very highly intuitive as well, too. And they're coming off as kind of closed off. I'm hearing like something about a book. So this is a closed book. It's someone who is not so easy for you all to read, because I was getting like closed book, open book. So I feel like I feel this person has trust issues. That's what I'm getting, because this person doesn't just allow just anybody into their, I'm hearing, auric and energy field. They don't just allow anyone to penetrate them. This person is coming off very highly psychic and intuitive as well, too, whoever this is that you all are aware of or know. So if you weren't aware of this before, well, this person is definitely psychic and they're definitely highly intuitive as well. But this person has a very keen sense of perception, so and just trust issues and boundary issues, so they don't just allow anyone into their personal space to just get to know them like that. I feel like it takes a while for this person to open up. I'm getting drawn to the moon that's in the card here. I don't know if you can all see that, but it's a moon right here. It looks like a full moon. But what this lets me know is that this person kind of like opens up gradually. It's phases, so there's levels to get to know this person is what I'm picking up. Like you're not gonna just I feel like this person will put you through some tests, is what I'm getting. This is the type of person who's going to put you through some type of test before they open up to you, before they just reveal who they are to you. So I feel like, in a sense, you're going to get a closed book. You may need to be kind of patient with this individual, because eventually, if it pays off, if you pass their tests, and I'm hearing mental, it could be a lot of mental tests with this person, then they will open up to you, and then they will be like an open book. So it's a very big thing with trust and loyalty with this particular person. And I'm hearing something about suspense. So maybe this person likes to play hard to get on purpose as well too. Could be the thing. Okay, so this person could be someone who's very like mental, and they could be into like mind games. When it comes to you all, let me see. I just feel like, yeah, you're just in a very doting and loving energy. Regardless if you're trying to or not, I feel like you're easily attracting love into you. I do feel like this person is, they're paying attention to you, and they notice you more than they are letting on. Like I said, this person is someone who kind of moves in phases and different stages, like the moon cycles. That could be something very like relevant to this individual. So maybe they have some type of significant water placement, or they could have very strong, maybe Piscean or Cancer placements, because I was definitely getting Cancer energy here. So they could have some very significant placements in their moon with those two energies, or they could just have very strong placements of maybe Pisces, or I'm hearing Scorpio or Cancer just in their birth chart. So this seems like this person could be like a water sign, or they could have water, significant water placements. I'm hearing water trine. So this person may have a water trine with all of some type of significant placement with all of the different water zodiac signs in their birth chart. Okay. Now, when it comes to how you're viewing this individual, we have the Five of Pentacles. I hope you all can see that, but it's the Five of Pentacles. And then how they're viewing you, we have the Hierophant. See? And that's what I'm saying. This person is looking at you with a sense of they want to commit to you. You're looking at this person that you're seeing. This person, I mean, for some of you, you may feel like this person doesn't have anything to offer, or you just may feel like this person has just abandoned you and left you out in the cold, or they don't even recognize you. They don't look at you in that sense. You kind of just kind of feel like iced out or just out in the cold. If this person has not actually like abandoned you and even come towards you, if you know this person, it could just be a sense of this person. You just kind of feel like you don't know where you stand with this person, and so it makes you feel like unwanted. But this individual is looking at you as someone who they could see themselves marrying. This is someone who sees you like that you require commitment, or they see that they know that they have to give you commitment to come towards you. So this could also be why this person is kind of like closed-lipped, I'm hearing. They could be being very closed-lipped about wanting to offer you some secure sense of commitment. Like, I feel like this person wants to lock you down. They're not telling you this. They may not be speaking this, but with the High Priestess, this is something that they're holding secret. So I do feel eventually, yes, this person sees that type of long-term picture with you. I feel marriage highly with this, but even if it's not a traditional marriage, because the Hierophant does signify traditional societal beliefs and practices, which would be marriage. But I'm also hearing common law marriage. So this could be like whatever you all's preferences is. This could be someone who just eventually wants to be with you. Like, they see themselves with you. They see themselves not going anywhere, or they could see themselves being with you very long term. So regardless if you actually solidify it in a legal manner or not, this person sees you as their wife or as their husband. They see you as the person who they want to be with. But you, on the other hand, over here with the Five of Pentacles, you feel like this person doesn't want to have anything to do with you. You feel like you and this person are not on the same page. or that like you're never going to get this offer, you know, like this person's never going to commit to you. This person's never like things are never going to go. Like I feel like some of you feel like this is what's missing. Like the next thing that's missing is like you're just missing that ring. You're just missing this person's last name, or you're just missing, you know, wanting to move in with this person. I mean, maybe for some of you it may be not as significant in terms of maybe a actual like engagement or wedding, but it could be just whatever, something that you two take as very serious. So maybe like buying a home together for some of you could be very serious. Maybe getting a pet together for some of you could be serious. Maybe getting like tattoos of each other on you. I mean, whatever that would be for you all, you would know. But I see this person seeing themselves as, you know, wanting something very permanent with you, okay? Now, as far as what's blocking you from this connection, we do have the Sun card. So I feel there's a level of optimism that you're needing to keep. And I know it can be very challenging for you because it seems like, you know, this person is really not giving you anything with this High Priestess energy, because they're not. Like, this person is highly secretive. This person is, like, keeping a lot close to the chest and not speaking to you on their plans. And like I said, this person likes to play mind games. And it's also, like I said, because there's levels to this person. So, I mean, part of it is mind games, but part of it also is the fact that this person just has trust issues. So they are slow to open up. But when this person opens up, this person wants long term, okay? So just know that those of you who this message is applying to, this person sees you as someone who is very special. They hold you in a high regard, okay? It's just this person's own process. And you can't rush someone's process. And I will be the first to say, when you have fire energy in your chart, you know, that can make you a little impatient, you know what I mean? So I got fire in my chart and I get it. So I understand it can be easier said than done is what I'm saying to you all, because it's easy for me to explain this to you because I'm able to see this person's perspective. So I can get why you all would have this level of being in this Five of Pentacles energy, because if you're not able to read this person's not giving you much. You know, they're putting you through these phases and tests to see, you know, if you're worthy of them opening up to. Then yeah, it can make you feel very impatient because this person's going to move on their own time. They're not going to move any faster than that, you know. But at the same time, you also have to respect a person for knowing who they are and what they want. You know, when you look at it from that perspective, it gives you a whole nother sense of appreciation for this person. Like, you don't just want someone who wants everyone. Yeah, I mean, for some of you know, this person seems, you know, to be very exclusive. So whoever this is that you all are, you know, connecting to and thinking about, you know, this person, I feel this person is very special, right? And I feel like, you know, your own blockage is just going to be trying to stay positive and optimistic and realize that things are working out, or they will eventually work out. Things will eventually work out. You just have to continue to stay positive. And stay optimistic. I just feel just stay optimistic. Don't allow your own thoughts, or don't allow time frames or circumstances around you, like you see in everybody else, get the things that you want, and just that, you know, going on around you, or just whatever you're conjuring up in your own head, stories you're telling yourself that this person doesn't want it. I mean, it could, you know, you could kind of lead yourself into a whirlwind of, you know, one little thing turning into a, you know, something bigger than what it actually is. And I just want to put you at ease, you know, so you don't continue to spiral out of control, feeling like something's never going to happen, or that, you know, you're not deserving, you're not worthy, or that this person doesn't care. Because this person does really care. It's just this person takes commitment very seriously. And, you know, this person is just hella secretive and, you know, slow to penetrate them. And they're not quick and easy to lock down. And I feel like, I personally feel like this is someone that's respectful, in that sense. Like that you would have to respect this person's choice, you know, to move how they move, because they know what they want. And I feel like if you know what you want as well too, you know, then continue to hold yourself in a high regard and know that you want someone who's going to be of quality. This person seems to be coming with that. They just, you know, moving at their own pace. Now, as far as the blockage for this person, we do have the Three of Wands. So it looks like distance can be in the way. So this could be someone at a long distance from you all. The Three of Wands definitely, yeah, signifies this could be like a major body of water separating you. This could be someone who is foreign or in a foreign country. Because now I'm hearing something about travel. So there could be something about travel that's keeping you and this individual separate. Is what I'm saying, but this person also, like, this is the thing, it's not in this person's control, is what I'm saying. So it's in their control that they haven't reached out to you, don't get me wrong, that is on them. So I'm not going to let them off the hook in that sense. However, there's something due to travel here that is out of this person's control, and this person seems to be just as like anxious? No, kind of impatient. They're kind of impatient. They're kind of irritated as well too about something to do with travel. So it's the same for them as well too. There's something with travel that they're slightly irritated as well too. That's what I'm saying. This could be someone from some for some of you at a long distance, or they're in another country. Okay, and with everything that's going on, because what is today? It is March 26th when I'm recording this. So, you know, things could definitely shift and change between now and when I put this out. But, yeah, it's March 26th, 2021. So, but they're not letting this on with the High Priestess energy. They're not giving this off that, you know, they're a little bit, you know, annoyed and irritated as well too. They're a little antsy. They're a little, you know, ready for things to move so that things can take off between the two of you, but they're not speaking this. So for whatever reason, they're not speaking that. You know what I'm saying? Like, we'll look more into the action. I feel like I know why this person isn't saying anything to you, but I don't want to jump too far ahead. So yeah, what's blocking you is definitely you're needing to see the light at the end of the tunnel and just realize that things are going to work out. And you're going to be very happy. You need to stay optimistic. And at the beginning, middle, and end of the day, you are responsible for your own sense of happiness. So you have to continue to do things that make you happy and that make you proud. I would say with the sun energy, the sun is Leo energy. So I would say, you know, just focus on yourself, tend to yourself, pamper yourself, treat yourself. And that's what I think of when I think of Leo. I just think Leos are all about themselves. You know, they have a very high defined sense of like self-love and self-appreciation. So I would say that could be something that you all may want to work on if that's something that you're lacking or something that you're starting to like question or wonder about. Like, just really get into your own self, you know, doing the things that you love and focusing on you. You know, but in the meantime, in between time, yeah, there's not really much this person can do because, you know, there's something with travel. I keep hearing travel ban, so this person is definitely somewhere where they can't get to you. Okay, next, what action does the two of you want to take towards each other? We have the Will card on your side, which is beautiful energy, and then on their side, ooh, they got this, they got the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, so interesting, the action they want to take towards you. I want to start with them. I feel like this person is waiting. Okay. This person is waiting. So that's the action they want to take towards you. I just feel like this person doesn't know what action they want to take towards you because now it kind of seems like this person is all up in their head now because of the circumstances that are going on with them not being able to travel to you. So it almost seems like this person is just trying. I heard second guessing. This person is kind of like second guessing themselves. So they could be kind of like, I'm hearing like almost like talking themselves out of a situation because they're not seeing it come into fruition yet with this whole travel situation. So they could be almost like reanalyzing their feelings for you and what they want to invest. And that could be another reason why they're not talking to you and saying this, because they're still kind of in this state of like indecision. I feel like they see you very long term. They see that you are someone who deserves this, but then at the same time, I don't know, they still kind of have some indecisive type of energy here with the Seven of Pentacles. But at the same time, the action that they want to take towards you, it's not much that they can really do at this point in time because, once again, they have travel. So I feel like that's just kind of something that they're just kind of heavily focused on and thinking about. And it's while they're thinking about this and having a lot of time to themselves, they're just having time to just really reanalyze things. So this is going to help this person get really clear about themselves, what they want from you, what they need from you, if they're going to be serious, and also, you know, what they'll be able to bring to the table. I almost feel like this is kind of working out in the best interest of you all, when it comes to this energy of distance and separation that you're having, because it's kind of like building, you know. It's like an energy that's building between the two of you. And then the Wheel card here, the action that you're wanting to take, I just feel like you're wanting things to turn in your favor. You know what I'm saying? Like you want things to move smoothly. You want to take control of your fate. You want to take control of your destiny. You want to move things along with this Wheel card. So there could be some type of energy that you all may be stepping into. Interesting. I feel like I'm gonna want to clarify this one for you all, because this Wheel card is very interesting energy here. There's some type of energy that you're wanting to step into, and I'm hearing manifest. So there's some type of energy that you're all wanting to step into to help with moving along, taking things in control. And it has to do with your love life. So this could be some of you all just actually taking a more authoritative approach. Just being maybe more some type of initiator on your side. Interesting energy. The last card, oh my goodness. The Ten of Pentacles. That is beautiful. And now this card is actually what is going to be the best potential outcome if the both of you take the action that you all are wanting to take. What is going to be the best potential outcome? The freaking Ten of Pentacles. And that's why I was saying I feel like this is all working out in you all's best interest, and it's going to lead to something really good. So it's a good thing that the two of you have distance, even though it may be really challenging and may be really hard, and it looks like that right now. And I'm hearing on paper it looks worse than what it actually is, but it's not. So I think from a spiritual context, it's not as bad, it's not as long, and there's more significance to the way things are playing out than what you're able to perceive. But in the natural, so on paper, it looks more challenging than what it actually is. But this is actually working out in you all's best favor, especially if it leads to the Ten of Pentacles, which is a card that if you're looking for love and romance, you want love to move in this direction for you. This is the ultimate shebang. Like, this is everything right here, okay? And it's, yeah, okay. All right. And then I just wanted to clarify the will as far as the action that you all want to take. And we have the Ace of Pentacles. So, yeah, there's some type of step that I feel that some of you all are going to be taking. I don't know. I'm hearing driving force. I don't know what that means or how that would relate to you all individually. But there is some type of step that you all will be taking that's going to move this connection forward. So it looks like there's some type of offer that you all may be wanting to extend to whoever this individual is over here. Interesting. This is interesting. I want to get another card on that because I'm hearing driving force. What is? I don't get that. Let me see. What is driving force? How does that relate? Hold on. What is driving force? Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm not gonna ruin the surprise, so you all will just have to wait and see.